welcome. We've got a full house of cheering fans, including Earl B., the home team's biggest fan.
Earl B., Earl B., he's our man. Earl B., Earl B., the home team's biggest fan.
Great day.
When it comes to sports in Lorain, your station to watch is TV20, Lorain City Schools Television.
On a Saturday, February 12th, from the Shot Palace at Lorain Admiral King High School. Good evening, everyone. I'm Ron Bacalar, along with my partner, Bob Braskich, our cameraman, producer, and director, Joe Bach, and it is Major Lorain City Basketball here at Admiral King. The Admirals playing host to the Saints of Lorain Southview. And just like the good old days of the 60s with Jim Bubbles Harris and the Mitch Gillum era, we've got a packed house here at Admiral King High School. Good to see the fans coming out. And Bob, these two teams tonight are coming here in this game after suffering major losses last night in Mentor. The Admirals, leading at one point by 17 points, wound up losing the game. The Saints in overtime, losing to Bedford.
In a game that would have given the Saints a share of the league championship, too, Ron.
So how do you overcome this type of thing in a big game like this?
I think when, as a player, this rivalry, you walk into the gym, you see 3,200 people here. I think last night has been long forgotten. I don't think it will have an effect on either team in any way.
And, of course, the Saints, I hear, remembering not so much the loss last night, but the loss to Admiral King on their own home floor.
Right.
The Admirals, probably, as you indicated, Bob, having already forgotten the loss against Mentor, recognizing they have a chance to be the crowned prince of basketball in the city of Lorain by having another win. So it's all for the marbles tonight.
And I think the keys to the game, Ron, are it's something we talk about all the time, tempo. I don't think Southview can beat the Admirals unless they control the tempo with their pressure. I don't think Southview can beat the Admirals unless they can press the Admirals. On the other hand, if the Admirals can't handle that kind of defensive heat intensity over the full 84 feet, they can't win. I think one of the keys is going to be the boards tonight. Southview, again, was beaten badly on the boards last night in Bedford, and if the Admirals can take advantage of that with their size, I mean, obviously that's going to it's a tremendous advantage they could capitalize on.
All right, the Admirals, as you indicated, Bob, definitely have the size, the height advantage. I think the Southview Saints have the hustle advantage.
Oh, there's no doubt about it, and that's why, Ron, tempo is so important. If the Admirals can make this a half-court game, I think they win. If the Saints can make it a full-court game and rebound the basketball, I think they win.
Okay, the Admirals, coached by Michael Scott, are 12-5 on the season. They are 5-4 in the Lake Division of the Lake Erie League. The Saints, coached by Brian Corey, are 13-5 on the season, 6-3 in the Erie Division of the Lake Erie League. This is what you might call one of those crossover games, but even more importantly, as we said, this is a inter-city rivalry that's going to just excite everyone here. And we hope you'll be excited too. We'll be back with the opening toss-up right after this. Timeout.
Hi, this is Tim McGrath.
Today and every day is the right time to support the American Red Cross, who gives disaster assistance to people when they need it most. You can help the victims of thousands of disasters across the country each year by making a financial gift to the American Red Cross Disaster Relief Fund, which enables the Red Cross to provide shelter, food, counseling, and other assistance to those in need. Please call 1-800-HELP now. Together, we can save a life.
Since 1921, your hometown financial professionals at First Federal Savings of Lorain have dedicated themselves to meeting the financial needs of their customers and surrounding communities. They offer a wide variety of financial investments as well as home mortgages to meet your every need. Loans on boats, cars, mobile homes, and other worthwhile purchases are also available. Whatever your financial need, First Federal Savings of Lorain is ready to help. 7 convenient locations locations to serve you in Lorain, Huron, Sandusky, Port Clinton, and now at 36690 Detroit Road in Avon. First Federal Savings of Lorain is an equal housing lender and FDIC insured. Looking for the right color, the right style, the right price for your floor coverings? Well, you can find them all at Ted's Floor Coverings, the only place you need to shop for affordable custom flooring. Whether you're looking for area rugs, carpeting, laminates, ceramic, or marble, you'll enjoy browsing through one of the largest showrooms in Northeast Ohio. Their talented staff will even help with your design questions. Ted's is proud to showcase the Kathy Ireland Shades of America collection. Shop at Ted's Floor Covering, 668 Broadway, downtown Lorain, a local company committed to our community. Ted Kahlo, president.
All right, back here at Lorain Admiral King High School in an overpacked Shot Palace. Well, not overpacked, but just beyond belief, something that we, Bob, have not seen in a long, long time. Going back to the days of Mitch Gillum and right. Going back to the days when we hosted the AAA sectional and district tournaments before they even went into Division 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and back in the days of Jim Bubbles Harris when they flocked here from all over Northeast Ohio to watch that young man play basketball. You can see every set of bleachers has been pulled out. Spanner boards have been put in, and we've got close to 3,000 people here at Admiral King High School. The officials for tonight's ball game are Craig Demian, Mark Penna, and Dave Zaborniak. And it's kind of ironic, back when I was faculty manager of athletics for Admiral King High School in the 80s, these three were hired to officiate freshman and JV games. So they've come a long way, and they do a yeoman's job officiating varsity basketball. There's the opening tip-off, and it comes down in favor of the Admirals. Paris Hilliard with the three-point effort off the front of the rim, no good.
Again, the Admirals rebound the miss. That's been the Saints' problem all season long.
Danny Bieber on the line, off the rim,
there
underneath.
Well, and that was the problem that, you know, we saw the Saints have against Shaw, and that was their problem last night. I talked to Coach Curry. They out-rebounded 2-1. Here, the Admirals hit three whacks at it.
Danny Hoskins called for traveling on that play. Ryan Jackson trying to pass it in underneath the basket, taken away by the Admirals. Jerry Al Nixon into the forecourt, pass to Hoskins. Hoskins the baseline, and a takeaway by Remakulis, could not control it, out of bounds. The starters for the Saints, Adrian Rodriguez, Brian Remakulis, Maurice Bennett, Ryan Jackson, and Maurice Johnson. For the Admirals, Jerry Al Nixon, Paris Hilliard, and there is a two-pointer popped in by James Penning Pinkerton. Dan Bieber and Danny Hoskins round out the Admirals' starting five. Maurice Bennett with the three-point effort. Rebound grabbed by Nixon, couldn't control it. Remakulis takes it away.
Yeah, it was one of those back pressure steals again.
Maurice Johnson ties it up at 2-2.
And here come the Saints. They're going to press. I didn't know if they were going to press tonight. They had a difficult time pressing King in the first game. Now this is more of a passive press, no traps.
Bieber gets it into Nixon. Nixon underneath the basket. Shot blocked by Rodriguez. Picked up by Hilliard. Gets it off to Pinkerton. Pinkerton to the basket. Won't drop. Jackson on the rebound. Remakulis with the three-pointer.
Yeah, this is a little bit of a containment press.
Southview taking the lead 5-2, and we're going to have
a
charging foul on Danny Hoskins.
Taken by the king of all charges, Maurice Bennett.
That young man is just unbelievable, sacrificing his body for the good of the team.
He had eight in that in our last broadcast, Ron, which has got to be.
Against Shaw, absolutely.
Right?
Rodriguez trying to get it into Bennett, just a little too hard and high. Beaver couldn't control the ball, taken away by Jackson, goes to the basket, he is fouled.
Well, you know, I can see what the Saints are trying to do. They're going to force either Hoskins or Beaver to bring the ball up, match up with them, and put a lot of heat on them, see if they can force a turnover there. They're going to try to keep it out of the hands of the guards. The Saints are.
That is the first foul on Beaver, and the second team foul.
Now, I'd like to see Ryan come to a one-count stop there and score the layup. Jackson at 65% for the year from the line.
Derek Williams now in the lineup for the Southview Saints, number 35. Apparently, Maurice Bennett has a cut lip.
I bet that's from taking that charge.
And they're tending to him right now at the bench.
Good job by getting on the floor there by Paris Hilliard.
Jerry Al Nixon on the dribble. He is fouled, and the foul is going to be on Adrian Rodriguez, his first, the team's first.
Well, we can see the Saints putting tremendous heat on whoever has the basketball.
Saints in the lead, 6-2. And another foul being called on Southview. The foul is on Jackson. His first, the team second. Pinkerton in the lane to the corner to Nixon. Nixon up with it off the rim. Remakulis on the rebound. Remakulis trying to get it to Rodriguez. He does. Rodriguez, reverse layup, good.
Well, that long bounce pass, very lucky to get that one through. Kings taking a timeout, down 8-2.
4 minutes, 55 seconds remaining in the first quarter. We welcome a brand new sponsor to WLCS TV20. Say your lawnmower needs service, your snowblower doesn't work, your riding mower needs repair. Well, who are you going to call? To avoid all this frustration and for no more worries, you can call Mark Furman at Mobile Mower Service. And that phone number, area code 440-315-0250. That's 315-0250. Mark Furman's Mobile Mower Service makes good old-fashioned house calls, believe it or not. Most services done on site at your home when it's convenient for you. No more storing that lawnmower in the trunk of your car, trying to lift it up. Just give Mark a call. He'll come and deal with it right at your home in your garage, 315-0250.
Saints changed defenses there. They came down in the zone.
Ryan Jackson getting the rebound on a missed shot by Beaver. Jackson goes up. And it's Hoskins on the rebound.
I think one of the strategies that the Saints are going to use today is they're going to change defenses on King, hoping to get him standing around.
Follows on Derek Williams. That's his first, the team's third. And almost a takeaway by Rodriguez. Couldn't control it. Out of bounds it goes.
Well, when you're playing against Remakulis and Rodriguez and Bennett, I mean, you've got to be aware of that. You can't be very casual with the basketball. You've got to handle it strong at all times.
Bieber on a three-pointer. Good.
Nice shot. Nice shot by Dan.
8-5, Southview with a three-point advantage. Down to 4 minutes remaining in the first quarter. We're halfway through. Remakulis with a three-point effort. Pinkerton on the rebound.
Notice King is getting all of the rebounds.
And that foul, obviously on Romakalis, his first and the team's fourth.
I mean, rebounding really is the key in this game for the Saints.
Antoine Powell, number 34, coming in the ball game now, replacing Jerry L. Nixon. Powell, 6'3", junior. Into Hoskins. Hoskins up, and he's fouled.
Well, that's the big advantage right there that the Admirals have, is you can put 6'5", Danny Hoskins, who's good, real good post moves on one block, and put Dan at 6'8", on the other block, and just reverse the basketball and try to pound it inside. And that's a great advantage that the Admirals have.
Foul is on Derek Williams. That's his second, the team's fifth. Hoskins at the line will shoot two.
Hoskins at 54% from the line for the year. Yeah, there's the
Bieber on the rebound, and two.
That's the key to this game for the Saints. They can't allow the stick back opportunities.
Admirals pulling to within 1 point, and an effort to get the ball from Rodriguez to Romakalis going out of bounds. Maurice Bennett back in the lineup for the Southview Saints, along with number 53, Alan Quattlebaum, a 6'2 senior. We indicated earlier that Antoine Powell on the floor for the Admirals replacing Nixon. He actually replaced Paris Hilliard.
And that gives the Admirals a big lineup.
Maurice Bennett going up, and it's good. And he is fouled by Nixon.
You got Jerry L. Nixon out there about 6'1", Powell's about 6'3", Pinkerton's about 6'4", Hoskins about 6'5", and Bieber at 6'8". That is a very substantial lineup.
First foul on Nixon, the team's third. And a three-point effort by Maurice Bennett.
This puts Antoine at top as the point guard for the Admirals, and Jerry L. plays the two spot, one of the wing positions.
Jerry L. Nixon in the lane, two.
It's a way to break the defense down off the dribble, Jerry L. Nice drag dribble.
11-9, Southview leading. 3 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Maurice Bennett with the three-point effort. Nixon on the rebound.
Again, one and done for the Saints. They get one shot at it, and it's over.
Nixon losing the ball. Rodriguez picks it up down the floor to Bennett. Bennett to the basket. In for two. Bennett now with 5 points in the ball game. 13-9, Southview by four.
See, I think the Admirals having a little difficulty, as I am, recognizing the Saints' defense. Nice shot by Pinkerton.
Pinkerton just inside the arc with 4 points in the ball game.
I'm confused.
13-11, Admirals trailing. Bennett off the side of the paint, no good, and it's Bieber on the rebound. Pinkerton again, just inside the arc. Hoskins trying to get it, he's fouled.
Another stick back opportunity, forcing the foul, and obviously the Danny Hoskins is going to, oh, they're going to say it's on the floor. I thought they were going to get another shot.
Foul is on Alan Quattlebaum, his first, the team's sixth.
Julius Blackman in the game now for Dan Bieber. Kimbrough in the game for Pinkerton. Paris Hilliard's going to come into the game for Jerry L. Nixon.
Kimbrough having the ball knocked away. Southview, Romakalis. Romakalis trying to get the baseline, and a blocking foul is going to be called on Jonathan Kimbrough, his first.
This game being called very tightly thus far, and I think that's a good approach by the officials. They're calling this very tightly. That very easily could have been a no call.
That's the fourth team foul. Underneath the basket, Maurice Bennett.
Well, just a well-executed out-of-bounds play there.
15-11, Southview with the four-point lead. Almost a takeaway by Bennett. Hoskins up. And it's Ryan Jackson on the rebound. Ramakalis in the paint, and he's going to be called for traveling.
Yeah, good call. But the tempo of the game thus far, you know, I think the Saints are controlling the tempo with their, you know, transition attempts. Tempo thus far, I'd have to say the Saints are controlling.
Nixon and Bieber back on the floor for the Admirals, along with Powell, Jordan Simmons, and Julius Bachman.
Well, little change in defense there. The Saints blitzed the basketball, forcing the turnover.
On the floor for the Saints, Maurice Bennett, Rodriguez, Ramakalis, Jackson, and Quattlebaum. Nixon on the rebound on the missed three-pointer by Ramakalis. Bieber lobbing it into Nixon. Back out to Powell, over to Bieber. Bieber in the lane, passes off to Nixon. Nixon goes into the paint, puts it up, and it won't drop.
Oh,
Rodriguez, before he went out of bounds, bounced it off the legs of Simmons.
Well, one of the things the Admirals are trying to do in their half-court man offense is post Jarrell Nixon up when he's being guarded by Adrian Rodriguez. They had some success with that in the first game.
1 minute remaining, first quarter. 15-11, Southview by four.
Admirals pressing full court on that last possession, forcing a turnover.
Right into the hands of Jarrell Nixon. And it's taken away from Bieber. Ramakalis passing to Jackson, intercepted by Blackman. And
nice idea, Julius.
As he is floating through the air, he calls a timeout.
Yeah, I mean, that's a nice idea.
All right, with timeout on the floor, a reminder that for all Lorain City School employees and spouses, the Lorain School Employees Credit Union looking forward to putting you in the driver's seat thanks to their super low rates on auto loans. So before you visit the dealer, visit the Lorain School Employees Credit Union. They'll help you get pre-approved so that you'll know exactly how much you have to spend. Plus, they'll help you lock in the lowest rate in town. Drive happy with Lorain School Employees Credit Union. Located at 4459 Oberlin Avenue in Suite 101. Open weekdays from 9 a.m. till 4:30 p.m. You can call them at 282-4600, 282-4600.
See, I don't know if it's a good idea to do that at this point in the first quarter and burn a timeout, but it showed that Julius Blackman's head was in the ball game.
Pinkerton up and in.
Good dump down there by Jarrell Nixon, finding Pinkerton open on the block.
Jay Pinkerton now with 6 points. Rodriguez on a three-pointer. Gets the rebound.
Good
passes
look
to Quattlebaum. Two. And that's the end of the first quarter.
Wow.
With the Southview Saints leading over the Admirals 17-13. We'll be back with more basketball action at the Shot Palace right after this timeout.
Your one-stop place for something really special is Impressions, corner of Oberlin Avenue and Tower Boulevard. T-shirts and sweatshirts personally designed to your specific needs. Anything from bears, trains to zebras, and specially designed hats as well. And don't forget Impressions, your one-stop spot for school jackets. See Dave, the designer expert at Impressions, Oberlin Avenue at Tower Boulevard, right here in Lorain.
freedom to think for yourself.
To disagree with the government.
Freedom to be equal.
To be different.
Freedom to raise a family.
To marry the man I love.
The freedom to worship the God of my choice.
To live with dignity.
The freedom to be me.
To be whatever I want to be.
Defending freedom for over 200 years.
Back here at the Shot Palace, Lorain Admiral King High School, second quarter getting underway. The Saints putting the ball into play, a missed shot by Rodriguez. Rebound Pinkerton. Jerry Al Nixon from the three-point range, he's got all net. Nixon now with 5 points. Pulls the Admirals to within one, 17-16 Southview. Maurice Bennett, wow. All net.
That was a good possession both ways. The Admirals played good defense. Saints were very patient on offense. Oh, a charging. It's Maurice Bennett again, Ron. Bandaged chin and all. Just took
and
another charge.
The foul is going to be on Jerry L. Nixon, his second, the team's fifth.
Now, Mike Scott doesn't believe that Maurice was set, and I'm not so sure I disagree with Mike. But nevertheless, the official called it a charge.
Maurice Bennett fakes the three, and he's going to get called for traveling. 20-16, Southview, increasing their lead by four.
Again, the Admirals not having any problem with the Saints' full-court pressure. Again, it's a token kind of containment press, but still no problem. Again, Ron, he's on the floor.
Number
34.
That is number three.
Wait a minute. He gets a second one. He took two in the last 20 seconds. Wow.
I'm keeping track in this ball game. Rodriguez on the three.
There you see what happens. You take the ball away from the offense, you come down and stroke a three. Those charges are huge plays, huge.
Hoskins with his first 2 points in the ball game. 23-18, Southview, 5-point advantage.
I mean, I just think the Admirals can pound it inside to Hoskins or Bieber. That last possession was a good one for them.
Antoine Powell, and he had the ball stripped by Remakulis, picked up by Rodriguez. Rodriguez to Bennett. Bennett inside the circle in the lane, tried to pass it off to Maurice Johnson. It went out of bounds.
When you play with these guys, Mo, you got to have your hands ready to play when you're standing around the basket because they penetrate, draw help, get your hands around your waist, getting ready to catch the basketball. They'll find you.
Paris Hilliard with a three-point attempt, blocked by Jackson. Loose ball picked up by Bennett. Remakulis stops in the paint. His shot is blocked by Blackman. Pinkerton, no good, gets his own stick back.
Good, a good job there by the Admirals, advancing the basketball. Pinkerton staying with it.
Jay Pinkerton now with 8 points. Ryan Jackson.
Saints want a charge call. I'm sorry, the Admirals want a charge call. We've got Julius Blackman, I believe, down.
He is down, and he is writhing in pain.
Right, and the Admirals bench is saying, hey, you're calling charges down there at the other end. What about our guy who just took a flop? And I saw it. That was a pretty good hit.
We've got 5 minutes and 19 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Southview leading by three, 23-20. Blackman is still down, being attended to by the trainer.
And getting up. He's going to be fine.
All right, a real quick reminder, Lorain Admiral King is offering before and after school tutorial services for all students not meeting state standards on the Ohio Proficiency Test. All seniors and juniors must meet state standards on the OPT before graduating. The next OPT test is the week of March 7th through the 18th. Before school tutoring will take place from 7:30 until 8:15, and after school tutoring 3 o'clock to 3:45, and tutoring is available throughout the entire school day. So parents, guardians, if you've got a son and or daughter that may not graduate because they have not passed all the proficiencies, get them involved in tutoring. Pinkerton's effort, no good. Stick back attempt by Rashawn Lagarde, now in the lineup for the Admirals. No good to Pinkerton.
Oh, good pass.
Lagarde! Oh. And that one, too, no good, but he is fouled.
Well, nice pass by Dan Beaver to find Pinkerton. Pinkerton drew help and dumped it off to Lagarde. Well done. It's the way to pass the basketball.
Foul is on Brian Remakulis. That's his second. Rashawn Lagarde at the line.
47% for the year.
Five minutes remaining in the second quarter, 23-20, make it 23-20. Rebound Jackson. Lagarde missing both foul opportunities. Maurice Johnson, no good. Bieber rebounding.
Ryan and Mo Johnson have to get on the offensive glass for the Saints. There are some opportunities for stickbacks. We're seeing the Admirals all over the glass, one and done for the Saints.
Rashawn Lagarde going up, shot blocked by Jackson. Jackson gets the ball, passes off to Rodriguez. He drops it in.
Well, good defensive play by Ryan.
Rodriguez now with 7 points.
Those are the kind of baskets the Saints are going to have to get.
Rashawn Lagarde, two more.
Yeah, nice ball movement right back at you by the Admirals, getting it inside.
25-22, Saints by three. Remakulis waits up and fouled.
Mm-hmm. Well, Rashawn Lagarde has come in and he's had a positive impact. He's obviously in the game for Danny Hoskins, but he's really hustling on the glass.
Foul is on Lagarde, his first, the team's seventh.
Remakulis at 75% from the free throw line for the year. Got some real good free throw shooters in this game. Jerriel Nixon, Dan Bieber, Remakulis, Bennett. Good, two pretty good free throw shooting teams.
And Remakulis drops them both in to give the Saints now a 5-point advantage, 27-22.
Antoine Powell, and he'll take over the point guard responsibilities. Jerriel Nixon will move over to the two spot. The Admirals just do a nice job against pressure. Very difficult team to press.
Bieber moves in the paint,
nice
passes
pass
off to Lagarde. Lagarde doesn't get it to drop, gets his own rebound. He's tied up, and we're going to have a jump ball. Possession arrow belonging to the Admirals.
One of the reasons the Admirals are tough to press is their big guys can handle the basketball, and they can pass over the defense, and they can bring the ball, too, as we saw there with Dan Bieber.
Nixon, and he's going to be called for traveling.
Wow, I see. I don't know about that. That looked like a pretty good spin move.
And assistant varsity coach Al Stacey questioning the
right
official, Mark Penna, on that call.
Now you can see right here the difference between the Admirals man-to-man and the Saints. The Admirals played a little bit more sloppy, a little bit more cautiously, where the Saints are out in the passing lanes and so forth.
Rodriguez, three-point effort. Ho-ho! Any doubt in your mind? That is number two for Rodriguez, and he's got 10 points. He and Bennett have the scoring honors thus far with 10 points each.
Back pressure by Adrian that time.
And Remakulis comes up with a loose ball up to Rodriguez in the forecourt. Rodriguez, another three-pointer.
Oh, he's feeling it. Wow.
He is hot. That is the third triple for Rodriguez. And he now is the leading scorer with 13. Ball knocked out of Nixon's hands, going out of bounds. The Admirals will keep it. Paris Hilliard and Danny Hoskins coming back in the lineup for the Admirals.
And Rodriguez came to the game just shooting 29%, which is not terrible from the three-point line, but much better tonight.
The Southview Saints with an 11-point lead. Danny Bieber, three-pointer.
There you go. There's not many 6'8 kids who can load that one up.
Bieber now with 8 points.
That was a big basket for the Admirals.
Bennett on the three-point attempt.
Oh, boy, here we go.
We are having a three-point circus here in the Shot Palace. Bieber again with the three-point effort. Pinkerton on the rebound.
And there's that
trying
second.
Trying to get it to drop off the glass. He's fouled.
Second shot opportunity. That's where the Saints' defense is weak. They just do not rebound the basketball well. And some of it's because of size, but there, it's a real problem.
Foul is on Quattlebaum. Pinkerton at the line.
Of course, Mo Johnson's not in the game right now. Second leading rebounder for the Saints.
Pinkerton now with 9 points. Chance to make it 10 on this one. 10-point lead for the Saints, 36-26. Pinkerton brings it down to a single-digit lead of 9.
Oh, don't do that. I saw it. The officials saw it. The officials are correct. Brian Machlis.
And Craig Demian is telling Pino exactly what the situation was.
Exactly. Brian kind of lost his cool a little bit there and shoved Paris Hilliard off, who was playing very aggressive defense. That was a good call. Not a smart thing to do in a close game like this. You got to maintain composure. It was a good call.
All right, the foul is on Brian Romakulis. That's his third.
I mean, Paris just got into Brian on that last possession, and
the ninth team foul for the Saints. Hilliard at the line with the bonus 1-1. Picking up his first point at the foul line.
And 58% from the air, but it's the little things in basketball. It's that kind of thing. It's a charge that can determine the outcome. That's 2 points for the Admirals and two that the Saints didn't get.
Hilliard pulls the Admirals to within 7. Rodriguez brings them back out to 9.
Well, you got to contain that dribble. The Admirals cannot allow that to happen. That was far too easy.
Pinkerton turnaround jumper no good. Hilliard on the rebound, gets it to Bieber. Can't get it to drop.
Stick
Hoskins
back basket.
Gets it.
Three whacks at it.
...38-31, Southview by 7.
Thus far, stick back opportunities keeping the Admirals in the game.
Rodriguez three-pointer. Rebound Nixon. Hoskins won't drop. Ryan Jackson on the rebound. Bennett in the paint.
Oh,
and he
wow.
it off the backboard.
A spin move and a drop step. Oh, geez. Craig Demian says that ball was last touched by Pinkerton. Southview basketball, 44 seconds left, 40-31.
Bennett with 15 points.
Paris Hilliard's just working defensively. That is good to see. Another good defender in the ballgame for the Admirals is Julius Blackman. Very good defender.
Rodriguez in the lane, and there's going to be a foul called.
See, I think Coach Corey wanted the Saints to hold the basketball for the final shot there. I don't think he wanted that, even though the Rodriguez is going to go to the line.
Foul is on Paris Hilliard. That's his first, the team's 8th.
Adrian, about 63% for the year from the line.
First crack at the line for Rodriguez tonight.
...14 seconds, down by nine. Admirals with the basketball.
Rodriguez had 13 points in the second quarter thus far, only two back in the first quarter.
Admirals gonna get stuck here, 3 seconds.
Jerry Al Nixon, three-point effort no good. That brings the second quarter to an end with the Admirals trailing by nine, Southview 40, Admiral King 31. Bob and I will be back with third quarter action right after this timeout.
Looking for the right color, the right style, the right price for your floor coverings? Well, you can find them all at Ted's Floor Coverings, the only place you need to shop for affordable custom flooring. Whether you're looking for area rugs, carpeting, laminates, ceramic, or marble, you'll enjoy browsing through one of the largest showrooms in Northeast Ohio. Their talented staff will even help with your design questions. Ted's is proud to showcase the Kathy Ireland Shades of America collection. Shop at Ted's Floor Covering, 668 Broadway, downtown Lorain, a local company committed to our community. Ted Kahlo, president. Since 1921, your hometown financial professionals at First Federal Savings of Lorain have dedicated themselves to meeting the financial needs of their customers and surrounding communities. They offer a wide variety of financial investments as well as home mortgages to meet your every need. Loans on boats, cars, mobile homes, and other worthwhile purchases are also available. Whatever your financial need, First Federal Savings of Lorain is ready to help. 7 convenient locations to serve you in Lorain, Huron, Sandusky, Port Clinton, and now at 36690 Detroit Road in Avon. First Federal Savings of Lorain is an equal housing lender and FDIC insured.
You might take meth because of how it feels. But this is how it feels to your heart. The only difference is, you can't rebuild a heart.
Back here at Lorain Admiral King High School in the Shot Palace. Good evening, everyone. Ron Bacalar along with Bob Braskich, our cameraman, producer, and director Joe Bach. And the third quarter getting underway. Southview Saints leading by 940-31.
Well, I think both teams played pretty well in the first half. You know, I think one of the differences.
Bennett on a missed three-pointer. Romakulis on the rebound. Bennett takes the pass down the lane and in for two.
The Saints had 6 threes.
Maurice Bennett now with 17 points.
The Saints again, very, very crafty, reaching and digging out the ball for steals.
Rodriguez losing it momentarily. Jackson picks it up, couldn't get it to drop. Hoskins on the rebound.
Okay, Saints coming out here in a 1-3-1 zone. We have never seen this before.
Rodriguez to Maurice Johnson.
Wow.
Johnson.
Saints coming out, not pressing. What they're going to try to do is change defenses and hope the Admirals stand around. Now they're in their man-to-man.
Hoskins.
Interesting little strategy, because I see this work more times than not at all levels. When you change defenses, offenses has a tendency to stand. Saints dodge a bullet there. That was point blank.
Bennett again from the three-point range. Bieber grabs it. ...44-31. Southview leading by 13. Bieber goes in the lane towards the basket. Gets his own stick back, no good.
Four
loose
whacks
ball
at
ball finally
it.
In the hands of Hoskins. Off the backboard and it falls.
Five whacks at it. Tremendous advantage the Admirals have on the glass.
Southview by 11, 44-33. Rodriguez cooled off on the three-point range.
I just think the Saints have to be a little bit more patient. They can get that shot anytime. Okay, now the Saints are in a man-to-man, and I think their pattern is going to be zone after maids, man after misses.
Foul's going to be called on Remakulis. That should be his fourth. And Remakulis will go to the bench. Coming in, Derek Williams.
And Danny Hoskins at 55% for the line. That's a big foul because having four takes a lot of his game away. You know, all the back pressure, all the reach, and all the steals, all the digging. I mean, he can't afford to do that anymore with four fouls. That's huge.
Looking at the scoring in the first half for the Admirals, Nixon with 5 points. Up goes Johnson, and it's Hoskins on the rebound. Terrace Hilliard had two, Lagarde with two. Danny Bieber had eight, Hoskins with four, and James Pinkerton, the only Admiral in double figures in the first half with 10. The Admirals had two triples. They were 4 of 8 at the foul line. The Southview Saints, Brian Remakulis with four, Ryan Jackson with one, Maurice Johnson with two, Quattlebaum with two, and Rodriguez and Bennett each had 15 points in the first half. Bieber goes up and he is fouled by Johnson.
Without question, the Admirals have a decisive advantage when they have Bieber on one block and Danny Hoskins on the other, and just reverse the basketball, look to pound it in there.
In the first half, the Southview Saints put on a clinic for triples with six. They were 3 of 6 at the foul line, so both teams shooting 50% at the foul line in the first half.
And Dan Bieber's another good foul shooter at just about 75% for the year.
Southview leading by 10, 44-34. Just under 5 minutes remaining in the third quarter.
Well, we always say make the easy pass.
Hoskins. Bennett saves it, gets it to Rodriguez. Rodriguez across court to Derek Williams, in and out. Paris Hilliard grabbing the loose ball.
I would think up by 10 points, the Saints would be a little bit more patient and force the Admirals to play some defense. Right now, it's one pass and a shot.
Harris Hilliard from the three-point range.
Well, they're going to get Dan Bieber for going over the back, I believe. But my pet peeve call, I think it gets called far too often, and there isn't any body contact. But that's what they're going to get. They're going to get Bieber, I believe, Ron.
That's the second personal foul on Dan Bieber. And the first team foul.
And I'm surprised to see this. The Admirals picking up full court. Saints a difficult team to press because of their guards. No damage done, though.
Jackson in the paint, dishes off to Johnson, rolls around and falls out. Johnson gets it back and puts it in.
Well, good job powering it up by Maurice.
Maurice Johnson now with 6 points. Pinkerton in the lane to the basket, and it's blocked by Johnson, but Johnson's going to be called for a blocking foul.
Well, just a nice cut there by Pinkerton from the weak side into the middle of the defense to get the basketball.
Second personal on Johnson, the third team foul. And we have a timeout on the floor. Again, we want to welcome a brand new sponsor to WLC STV20, Mark Furman of Mobile More Service, servicing the area's power equipment needs for over 30 years. And believe it or not, he makes house calls. You heard me right. House calls. You call him, he comes to your house. Servicing most makes, including Sears, MTD, Toro, Arians, Lawn Boy, Snapper, Murray. Authorized Briggs & Stratton Mobile Service Dealer. Service on the site for fast, experienced professional service. Give him a call at 315-0250. That's a cell phone, folks. 440 is the area code. 315-0250. And I bet it's Verizon, because I have a 315 on my cell phone. I'm going to have to give this guy a
That's
call.
An interesting concept. Mobile come and fix your
Absolutely.
That's an interesting concept.
You know, some of the older folks have a problem trying to get that big lawnmower in the trunk of a car.
Yeah, that's
or
right.
Or who can possibly take it somewhere.
It sounds like a good idea to me.
Absolutely.
Jay Pinkerton at the line, 62% for the year. Big night last night against Menor with 25 points.
Pinkerton now with 11 points. Long pass to Johnson, to Rodriguez. Back to Johnson, but it goes out of bounds.
Now, Brian Corey took that last time out for a reason. He evidently didn't like what he saw either. Changing defense is now picking up full court man-to-man. But still, again, it's not the usual trapping kind of, blitzing kind of. Oh, yes, it is.
Hoskins fakes the three, goes into the lane, passes off to Pinkerton.
Oh, that
two.
Was well done. Nice spin move in the lane by Hoskins. Drawing help, find Pinkerton, flashing in from the baseline. Good basketball right there. Oh, the Admiral's in a little trapping defense.
Rodriguez. Now with 17 points. Both he and Bennett tied for high point honors, 17 each. Nixon underneath to Kimbrough, no good, and it's Ryan Jackson grabbing it.
Saints dodge a bullet. Admirals did everything right there except put it in the hole.
Jackson, his shot blocked by Pinkerton, going out of bounds. Southview will keep it. 48-37, Southview leading by 11 with 2:34 remaining in the third quarter. By the way, in the junior varsity game, the Southview Saints.
Oh,
and there's
boy.
A basket by Bennett.
Well, he just snuck inside there and snuck inside the defense.
Bennett now with 19. In the junior varsity game, Southview 50, Admiral King 47. Pinkerton trying to take the baseline, the ball off of Derek Williams. King will keep it. The ironic thing is that Admiral King led through most of that ball game. Southview put on the pressure in the fourth quarter in the closing minutes, grabbed the points, tied it up, and went on ahead on some three-pointers and won the ball game 50-47. Jordan Simmons from a three-point range.
It just seems like the Admirals offensively right now are in some disarray, some disorganized. They aren't playing with a purpose. And defensively, they're getting beat a little bit off the dribble.
Rodriguez, three-pointer, off the rim. Bennett gets it.
See, it's tough to blitz and trap against the Saints because they shoot the three ball so well. They get it out of the trap, reverse it, and they shoot the three.
And Brian Corey wants a 30-second timeout. Talk to his Southview players with a minute and 48 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Lorain School employees and spouses, the Lorain School Employees Credit Union makes banking even better. That's because they offer a variety of savings and checking accounts, including certificates of deposits that help you do more with your money. So speak with any of their representatives for assistance in selecting the account that's right for you. And make the most of your money with the Lorain School Employees Credit Union, who, by the way, are celebrating their 50th anniversary. And some of the old-timers from the Lorain School Employees Credit Union will be on the Diaz at the TV20 studios for a focus program. We'll be talking to some of them and reminiscing about how it all got started and how it's developed and progressed through the years. And speaking of focus, I want you to really be paying attention in the month of February when you're going to hear my partner Bob Braskich talk about the presidents of the United States who served more than one term and whether they were successful or failure type of second terms. Very fascinating. You'll also have an opportunity, I think this week, to watch Focus with Paul Bieber talking about Teddy Roosevelt and Hayes and Woodrow Wilson.
Up by 13 with a minute 32 left, and Saints are holding the basketball. I think this is a pretty good move. They're running that little high triangle they run.
Rodriguez does the spin, gives it to Johnson, and it goes in.
That was a clinic right there. That was a clinic.
Hoskins has the opening, and he goes to the basket. He is fouled.
But on the other end, Danny Hoskins has the basketball out here a little below foul line extended. Everybody ran away from him, gave him a clear path to the basket, and he took advantage of it. Admirals have got to crank up the intensity in this game. They've got to start playing harder, crank up the intensity. They've got to get some defensive stops. They've got to score off their defense. And I think they can get back in if they pound it inside and smack the boards. But they've got to crank up the intensity level. They need more energy out there.
Fouls on Quattlebaum. He comes to the bench. That was his third. Ryan Jackson on the missed foul shot, getting the rebound.
Watch this.
Derek Williams and Pinkerton on the block. Hoskins coming into the forecourt, into the lane.
Wow, Maurice Bennett just took another charge, didn't get the call.
Derek Williams to Jackson. Jackson pauses, in for two.
All right, the Admirals have to get sprint back on defense. They've been beaten down the floor last two possessions. That's going to be Saints basketball.
54-38. The Admirals are trailing by 16 points. And Coach Mike Scott calling a timeout with 41 seconds remaining in the third quarter, a full timeout. A reminder to the Lorain Southview Adult Athletic Booster Club, there's going to be a fish fry on Friday, March 11th from 4:30 until 7 o'clock. A half a pound of fish, fries, coleslaw, roll with butter. Donation just $12. All proceeds benefit the Southview Fast Pitch Softball Program. If you would like to purchase any tickets for that fish fry for March 11th, locate a softball player, or you can call Major Richard Brown at 240-1262. That's 240-1262 for tickets. And for you Lorain City School employees, you can get the money you need for the things that you want with the Lorain School Employees Credit Union. They offer the lowest rates and attractive terms for home improvement loans, holiday loans, vacation loans, mortgage loans, bill consolidation, and much more. Ask for details and apply as soon as possible. Lorain School Employees Credit Union, banking made better. Open weekdays from 9 till 4:30.
Well, Mike Scott.
And a takeaway by Pinkerton. No good. Stick back by Hoskins, and it goes out of bounds.
Good move by Mike Scott. He put his two quickest defensive guards in the game, Kimbrough and Hilliard. And the rest of the lineup is the two big guys plus Pinkerton. They realize they've got to get after the basketball, and that worked on that last possession. Now, offensively, the problem for the Admirals is they have nothing from the perimeter. They're going to have to pound it inside, which is okay.
Paris Hilliard fakes the three, gets it out to Kimbrough. Kimbrough to Bieber. Bieber from the three-point range, rolls around, drops out. Rodriguez brings it into the forecourt.
12 seconds left. The Saints will play for the last shot. We're down to eight.
Saints leading by 16. Kimbrough, and he's going to get called for a foul trying to get the ball away from Rodriguez.
Okay, not a bad foul because it's not a shooting situation. The Admirals are forced to take the basketball back out of bounds. That is a good foul. With only 3.9 with the ball out of bounds, it's much more difficult to score.
That is the second foul on Kimbrough, only the second team foul.
And that's not a bad foul either, unless they're going to put Bennett at the line, which they are. Well, they are. I'm surprised. The officials have been coached up this year that if somebody's making a move to the basket, you blow the whistle on a foul. Oh, nah, they changed their mind. Now it's going back out of bounds. So that was not a bad foul because you get to reset your defense. Now there's only 1.2.
Foul is on Paris Hilliard, his second, the team's third. Southview with four team fouls. Pass into Jackson, goes up, and the shot is blocked by Bieber. And Jackson goes down. He is still down on the floor.
And Coach Corey saying, why wasn't that a foul?
All right, that's the end of the third quarter with the score. Southview 54, Admiral King 38. We'll be back with the fourth and final quarter as Jackson gets up right after this timeout.
Your one-stop place for something really special is Impressions, corner of Oberlin Avenue and Tower Boulevard. T-shirts and sweatshirts personally designed to your specific needs. Anything from bears, trains to zebras, and specially designed hats as well. And don't forget Impressions, your one-stop spot for school jackets. See Dave, the designer expert at Impressions, Oberlin Avenue at Tower Boulevard, right here in Lorain.
Well, I won't back down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. And I won't back down.
All right, fourth and final quarter here at the Shot Palace. Bieber to Kimbrough, to Pinkerton. Pinkerton up, and he passes to Hoskins, taken away by Ryan Jackson. Jackson trying to get it to Johnson, taken away by the Admirals. Here comes Pinkerton up, and Johnson on the rebound.
Let's see how patient the Saints are with a 16-point lead.
Remakulis back in the lineup for the Saints with four personal fouls.
Yeah, they're being very patient. This is pretty smart basketball here.
Looking at the scoring by quarterback in the first quarter, the Admirals with 13, the Saints with 17. Johnson couldn't get his to go in. Jackson on the rebound, gets it back up and puts it in, and a whistle.
Wow, that was a big basket. Ryan just powered that thing up, but, you know, through the arms of Danny Hoskins and Dan Bieber.
Foul is on Bieber, his third.
Big basket to put the Saints up by 18, and to come back against the Saints when you're down is very difficult because their guards are so good. They handle it so well, and they're good foul shooters. They got the ability to hold it. The Saints back in a 1-3-1 zone. We have never seen them play this zone before this year.
Hoskins couldn't get it to drop. Bieber gets the stick back.
See, I just think the Admirals can do that all night long, regardless of which defense the Saints are in.
Bennett goes to the basket. Finally loses the ball. Bieber grabs it.
See, that's not good basketball there by the Saints. What you want to do, you know, if you are going to shoot the ball, you want to make sure you take off 25, 30 seconds every time down. Don't force things.
Paris Hilliard from the line.
Stick back.
Hoskins. Hilliard.
Oh!
And finally, Paris Hilliard.
Again, the Admirals score in a stick-back situation. Except, you know, that time, instead of 6'8 and 6'5, it was a little bitty 5'9 Hilliard staying after it. Good job, Paris. Well, Ryan picked up his dribble.
Bennett on the three, and Hoskins on the rebound.
See, I just don't know why you shoot that shot in this situation up by 15. Eat the clock up.
Bieber with a three. And the foul is going to be called on Maurice Bennett.
You see, the Saints, you know, shoot the three ball when you really don't have to. It obviously gives the Admirals the basketball back, and it creates a foul situation.
That is the first personal on Bennett, the 15 foul.
You know, the game didn't have to unfold this way.
Nixon fakes the three, gets it to Kimbrough, up and off the rim. Remakulis. And a reach-in foul on Hoskins. That is the first personal on Hoskins, the 6'5 junior.
Ron, can I double-check something with you, foul situation? Does Remakulis have four, or does he have three?
I've got him with four.
Okay, I'm sure you're right, because he's
they
not
don't
posted.
Have him on
they
the board.
They don't have him posted, okay.
That is the sixth team foul on the Admirals.
Official telling Mike Scott to have a seat.
Let's hope the fuses don't get
too
short, and there's
well,
a technical.
Mike just got whacked with one. And that all started with the officials needing a little space over there to, in the coach's box to enter the basketball, and disagreement over who could stand in the coach's box. And then Mike sat down and then evidently said something.
Remakulis will shoot two. And he makes them both. Remakulis now with 7 points in the ball game.
Okay, good job.
Pinkerton saves the ball, but throws it errantly, and it's picked off by Johnson.
Good job there by Jerry L. Nixon defensively.
Rodriguez. Hoskins from the three.
Oh,
he's got it.
Wow. 4:30, down by 16. I hope people aren't tuning out or leaving. This is not over. Again, it's an uphill battle, but I've seen it happen before.
Long pass across court to Remakulis. Dishes off to Johnson. All alone.
Well, that's what makes them so tough. They spread the floor, then they beat you off the dribble, draw help, and they're very adept at passing the basketball.
And Admiral King calling a full timeout. Lorain Admiral King OPT strategy class, March 10th in the Lorain Admiral King cafeteria. Lorain Admiral King will offer a test-taking class to all students taking the Ohio Proficiency Test and the Ohio Graduation Test. The class will review key information and test-taking strategies, which will be very valuable prior to taking the test. All seniors and juniors must meet state standards before graduating from high school. Please contact David Hall at Lorain Admiral King if you have questions or need further information. Call him at 282-9191. That's David Hall at 282-9191. The Lorain Admiral King Ohio Proficiency Test Strategy Class on March 10th in the LAK cafeteria. And a reminder, too, to all Lorain City School employees, if you are an employee of the Lorain Board of Education or an employee's family member, You're eligible for the lowest rates, the best products, and the friendliest service in banking with Lorain School Employees Credit Union. Speak with them about a membership as soon as possible and start reaping the rewards of membership with Lorain School Employees Credit Union.
Stick back opportunity again.
Unable to make it happen.
That's
Rodriguez with the ball. Rodriguez moves in the lane to the basket. Won't drop. Bieber on the rebound.
See, the Saints spread you out.
Paris Hilliard getting it back to Hoskins. Hoskins going to the basket. No good. Out of bounds. It will belong to the Admirals.
Then they beat you off the dribble. They force help and they dish. They're just good at it.
Southview Saints leading by 18, 63-45 with 3:35 remaining in the ball game. Hoskins three-pointer. Gets his own rebound. Up again, and he's fouled.
The Saints just have got to start doing a better job of rebounding basketball.
Foul is on Rodriguez. That's his second.
If they're going to have any impact over there in that tournament, I mean, you just can't allow all of these second and third and fourth shot opportunities.
The Admirals with 17 fouls and the Saints with six. Hoskins at the line.
You know, and the reason for the foul discrepancy is, you know, the Saints attacking the basket off the dribble and getting fouled, or in transition, attacking the basket and getting fouled. You know, I think the Admirals could go to the line a lot too if they pound it inside.
Jackson gets it to Bennett, goes up, it's good, and he is fouled.
Again, not picked up down the floor. Too many people standing defensively, not watching the basketball, not seeing the ball.
Foul is on Pinkerton, that's his first. And the team's eighth. And Bennett moves the Saints out to a 21-point lead, 66-45. Bieber underneath the basket, can't get it to go, and he is fouled.
See, that's what I think has been there all night.
Foul is on Maurice Johnson, his third, and the team's seventh.
You know, and I just think when you have the height advantage of Bieber at 6'8 and Hoskins at 6'5, if you pound it inside, more times than not, you're either going to get fouled or you're going to score. And both of those two guys are good foul shooters. Bieber at 75% or so.
Well, tonight at the foul line, Bieber is at 50%. Bennett going up.
Well, again, the Admiral's getting beaten down the floor in transition and dodged a bullet that very easily could have been a layup.
Hoskins, three-point range, no good. Remakulis comes up with it, gets it to Rodriguez. Rodriguez dribbling in the backcourt to Bennett. Bennett across the timeline.
Well, this is where the Saints are good. They spread you.
And it's obvious the Saints are going to take a few ticks off the clock as we wind down to 2 minutes and 30 seconds.
Right. If you go out there and pressure them, they beat you off the dribble. I mean, this is where they're tough. And they're good foul shooters, so when they go to the line, they convert.
Foul is on Kimbrough, Jonathan Kimbrough, his third. And that is going to put Maurice Bennett at the line.
Bennett at 68% from the line. Anything over 65 at the high school level for boys is very good.
Bennett 2-for-2 at the foul line tonight. His two appearances after having made a basket. Fouled while shooting, and the basket good.
Both players starting to sub.
Michael Schuster now in the ball game for the Admirals, number 5, a 5'10 junior.
And that's a good move when, you know, two friends, two crosstown teams, you see one of the teams sub, it's a good idea. Both sub, get all your players in the game.
Hoskins, Blackman, Lagarde, Schuster, and Simmons on the court for the Admirals. Bennett 4-for-4 at the foul line tonight. 68-47, 21-point lead for the Southview Saints.
And all of the Southview starters out of the ball game too.
Simmons on a three-point effort. Lagarde tried to go up, having gotten the rebound. For the Saints now on the floor, Robert Laurenti, number 25, a 5'10 senior. Number 44 is Lamar Miller, a 5'10 senior. Derek Williams is back, along with Quattlebaum. Quattlebaum gets the rebound. And number 42 is Matt Williams, a 6'3 sophomore.
Well, I think it's out of reach now. I mean, it's just been a tremendous effort here by the Saints.
And many of the fans are beginning to file out of the shot palace with 2:06 remaining. I mean, the foul was on Qualabom, his fourth.
Well, they had a couple of scares as the week unfolded with Ryan Jackson's possible health problem. Of course, he was cleared by the doctor to play tonight. But, I mean, it was an up-and-down week for the Saints. And they finished it out very, very well. They're playing excellently here.
68-48, 2:05, Saints by 20. Lagarde, 2. And a takeaway, Rashawn Lagarde down the lane, and Quattlebaum apparently had the ball because there is no foul being called. So he had to block the shot attempt. And they're saying the ball belongs to the Southview Saints. When it rains, it pours. 68-50.
Well, you know, the Admirals have been in the 70s, mid-70s, all year long in most of their games, and they're at 50. I mean, you have to give the Saints some credit here. I mean, they did a nice job defensively.
And that's something you have stressed time and time again, defense over height anytime.
Two good teams play, and we've got two good teams playing here. The team that executes and plays the hardest with the most intensity and plays the best half-court defense is going to win 90% of the time. And that's especially true when you get down into the tournament, you get deeper into the tournament. Everybody plays good half-court defense. It's a key.
Follows on Julius Blackman, his first. Alan Quattlebaum at the line. Chance to put the Saints back out by 20.
You know, I never thought this was going to be. I thought this was going to be a nail biter to go down to the last possession. I'm very,
well,
very
you
surprised.
And a lot of other folks, including yours truly.
I'm very surprised.
Kimbrough. Simmons on the rebound. Back
nice
to
pass.
Kimbrough and two. Kimbrough with his first 2 points in the ball game. We're down to 55 seconds remaining. Quattlebaum, he's got two. His toes were on the line.
You know, I thought in the game the
Schuster with a three.
The changing defenses of the on the part of the Saints. I thought that was a nice little wrinkle. You know, I thought it really had an effect in the second half.
Derek Williams in the lane, up. Rebound fought for, loose ball, and we're going to have a jump ball. Possession arrow belongs to Southview with 17 seconds remaining.
But for the Saints to do well from here on out, they're really going to have to tighten up and resolve this rebounding issue. And I think the Admirals have to tighten up on the half-court defense. They've got to resolve that issue.
Derek Williams couldn't control it. Off of him, out of bounds. Admiral King will have one more opportunity to get some points.
And then offensively to play more with a purpose. It's like they play without an identity.
Schuster with another three-pointer off the rim. Williams on the rebound. Matt Williams up to Lamar Miller. Miller with the final shot of the ball game. No good, and that's the end of the game with the Southview Saints seeking revenge and getting it 72-55. Bob and I will be back to wrap it all up right after this timeout.
For the people in our armed forces, it's a time of sacrifice, a time of duty. That's why we've joined together to form the Armed Forces Relief Trust to help military families cope with financial and medical emergencies at home. The four military aid societies gave millions last year to cover unexpected medical expenses, child care, and more. But with so many overseas, the need is greater than ever. They're serving us. Let's serve them in return.
Mom? Dad?
You are miserable parents. I snuck out.
You caught me.
I lied. You knew.
I pushed.
And you pushed back.
Invaded my privacy.
My privacy?
I hated it.
I hated you.
Why couldn't you leave me alone?
Just leave me alone.
I thought you were the worst parents in the world.
I thought you were the worst parents in the world.
Thanks.
Well, if the talk across town was, hey, you guys beat us on our court, we're coming over to your shop palace and we're going to beat you. If that was the talk, it came true tonight here at the shop palace. The first time around, it was Admiral King beating Southview by 8 points, 71-63. Tonight, the Saints beat the Admirals by 17 points, 72-55. Your thoughts on the game, Bob?
You know, we said going in, Ron, that the team that controlled the tempo would most likely win. And I think that's what we saw tonight. I think Southview controlled the tempo of the basketball game with their hustling defense, and they pushed the ball offensively up the court, made it an up-and-down transition game. And when they got ahead, you know, being a very good passing, catching, spread the floor, you know, find the open man, good foul shooting team, they're a very difficult team to track down. And so I think they controlled the game and made it more of an 84-foot affair as opposed to what the Admirals do best, which is a half-court game pounding it inside.
Well, the Admirals, right at the very beginning of the first quarter, had the only lead in the ball game when Jay Pinkerton put in a basket and led 2-0. After that, it was all Southview. Southview outscored the Admirals in all four quarters. Looking at the scoring, the Admirals at the end of the first eight had 13 points, Southview 17. In the second quarter, the Saints put in 23 while the Admirals dropped in 18. The locker room score was 40-31, Saints by 9. In the third quarter, the Saints scored 14 points, holding the Admirals to just 7, 54-38. And in the fourth and final quarter, just 1 point separated the two. Southview put in 18, Admiral King 17 for the final 72-55. The Admirals were 10 of 22 at the foul line. They had four triples, two in the first half and two in the second half. The Southview Saints had six triples in the first half. They didn't drop a single one in the second half. But where they shined was at the foul line. They were 3 of 6 in the first half, 11 of 14 for the game. They were 8 of 8 at the foul line in the second half. Looking at the individual scoring, and these are not official figures, we try our best to keep the score and tell you what's happening all at the same time. We have Jerry L. Nixon with 5 points, all coming in the first half. Paris Hilliard with four. Michael Schuster with a three-pointer in the fourth quarter. Jonathan Kimbrough with 2 points. Rashawn Lagarde had five. And then three of the Admirals in double figures. Danny Hoskins with 11, Dan Bieber with 12, and the high point man for the Admirals, James Pinkerton, with 13 points. For the victorious Southview Saints, it was Alan Quattlebaum with 6 points, Ryan Jackson had 6 points, Brian Romakulis just 7 points, one of the rare times that he did not score in double figures. But the other three Southview Saints in the ball game did have double figures. Maurice Johnson with 10. Adrian Rodriguez had 19 points, three triples in the second quarter. And the high scorer for the Admirals, or for the Saints and for the game, Maurice Bennett with 24 points. and he took three charges right. to increase that number.
Right, right.
Any
that
other thoughts?
Amazing.
Well, you know, really, I hate to, I don't like to single individual players out, but I thought Adrian Rodriguez really played a nice ball game tonight, especially in the first half. And I see positive things out there on both sides. Iran, you know, I think the Admirals are getting better. I think all they have to do is tighten up that half-court defense a little bit, and the Saints certainly played very well tonight, and they've got to resolve the rebounding situation. And I think both teams could make some noise in the tournament. And well, I see good things on both sides.
And that's the key thing. Tournament is just around the corner.
Right.
There's only one more week left of the regular high school basketball season, and then it's all tournament. Win and continue, lose, and you are
that's
out.
Right.
And even though the Admirals were seeded number one, they have a first-round bye. They will play the winner of the Lakewood St. Ed's and Avon Lake game. Now, last night, the Admirals got beat by Mentor despite leading at one point by 17 points. And you told us Lakewood St. Edwards beat Mentor by how many?
19 the week
19.
Before. And St. Ed's wasn't even seeded. And a lot of people looked at their record and said, well, they can't be that good. But if you take a look at their record, they're playing, you know, a state ranked record. And so their winning percentage isn't that great, but they're very formidable.
The Southview Saints, meanwhile, also with a first-round bye in the sectional tournament. They will be playing on a Saturday night. The Admirals will be playing the night before on a Friday, all at Midview. But they do have, as we said, one more week of basketball remaining. The Admirals are now 12-6 on the season. Mm-hmm. The Saints are 14-5. And our next encounter with high school basketball, Bob, will be next week Friday. That will be the 18th of February. You and I will be here at the Shot Palace when the Admirals take on the Lakewood Rangers in an LEL Lake Division game. And across town at Southview, the Saints, and I'm trying to remember if you Garfield Heights. The Saints will be going against Garfield Heights and
Maple Heights.
All right. Well, it had to be one of those heights, Maple Heights. And that game will also be on TV20 with our second backup crew handling that particular job. So any closing comments?
Could we mention that the Lady Admirals, speaking of Lakewood, won a big one this afternoon when they beat the Lady Rangers 51-49. So this was kind of a nice little finish for them.
Congratulations to Paul Bieber and the Lady Admirals. They struggled through the opening part of the season, but towards the end they started stacking up some wins.
Right, they became very competitive.
And they will be going into tournament play this coming week. So good luck to the Admirals, the Lady Admirals, and the Lady Saints as well as they encounter tournament action at Westlake High School. And again, the score of the JV game, Southview 50, Admiral King 47. So a clean sweep by the Saints here in the Shot Palace. And no one has bragging rights other than the fact the Saints' victory tonight was by more points than the Admirals over at Southview.
And Joe says he likes the split, so that's pretty good.
Okay.
1-1.
Is that like kissing your sister?
I guess.
Okay. Well, until next week, Friday, when we will be here at Admiral King when they take on Lakewood. And our backup crew will be at Southview for the Southview Maple Heights basketball game. Till then, for my partner, Bob Braskich, our cameraman, producer, and director, Joe Bach, I'm Ron Bacalar. Good night, everyone.
This has been a production of Lorain City Schools, TV20 WLCS.
To purchase a high-quality copy of the program you just viewed, please call Lorain City Schools Television at 282-8400.